Oh, it's so exciting. People on the Android Excel have had this for years, and now it's finally here. Data from picture comes to desktop Excel. Let's take a look. Now look, I have to tell you a little story. This was 1989. I was fresh out of college. I was working for a company in Akron, Ohio, a big company meeting. The president of the company was speaking, and he brought up our chief engineer, a great guy named Raj, right? And Raj was there to demo this amazing new ability where someone could speak to one of our computers that we manufactured. Oh, poor Raj, in front of 200 people. It was a crash and burn. It missed almost everything he said. That was 1989, and today, 2022, watch what we can do. Alexa, what time is it?
The time is 6:24 a.m.
We can talk to these devices all day, and it just works. So I don't want to be negative here. This is like a version 2 of this feature, and they're going to get there. It may not be there today, but it's a great first step. Check this out on the data tab right here in the Power Query group, this new thing called From Picture that has nothing to do with Power Query, doesn't run it through Power Query. It seems like it's a pretty weird place to add it, but okay. Where are we going to get the data to test this out? I could be a real jerk and go out to Unsplash and grab a photo of some data, but that wouldn't be fair. So let's give them a good shot and create nicely formed data. Here's a fast look at how I did it. Fill handle for months, fill handle for names, a rand array to fill in the numbers. Paste values, February is currency, April with a comma, May a little bit wider, wind snap, grid lines off, wind snap again. All right, so we're gonna try that out. Data from picture, we have a choice either from a file or from a clipboard. I'll choose the one with no grid lines. Over here, we're analyzing our image, 6%, 7%. That was fast, right? And under review, they say there were two things they're not sure of. I had the word flow, a lady's name, flow, and they chose F-I-O. All right, good, let me fix that one. Good catch, Excel. And then Ike, which is actually correct, capital I-K-E, that one's correct. All right, so we do the review and then accept insert data. They're going to warn me, you are responsible for validating the accuracy of all data. All right, so that you read that and then click insert data. Okay, let's compare this to the original photo. Hang on a second. All right, so what did we learn? You see that I left the labels left aligned. That's the way that they came out. And that caused a lot of misalignment. But the thing that really seemed to have caused problems was here in the February column, some of the numbers are 4 digits before the decimal and some are 5. And that seemed to confuse things. I'm not sure why Excel thought that 15253 and 19907 should be in the same cell. All right, but let's be positive here. They did actually get all the numbers right. I went through and checked them all. And starting from this, I could use some Excel skills to clean this up faster than it would have taken me to type the whole thing. Here's a quick look at that. It's a lot of cutting and pasting at first, deleting some columns, and then getting stuff out of the way so I could do a text to columns. And I actually missed the text to columns, so I'm gonna have to do another text to columns there. More cutting and pasting, delete two columns. Okay, so again, here's the original picture. Here's after I cleaned up the data. Here's a paste of the original data, and it did get 100% of them right. So that's a really good first test. I wondered if shooting the photo with the grid lines in would actually help. Like maybe that would kind of cue Excel that this Jan and all of these belong together. And fortunately though, data from picture, picture from file with grid lines. All right, same issue with flow. oddly enough, right, having the grid lines there actually caused problems. Like this 5323, I lost the 5 and the 00 changed to, what is that, lowercase o's. So that's really strange that having grid lines really seemed to have caused more problems. The thing that did really seem to help is lining all of the headings up with the column. And of course, you know, if you had the ability to do that, you wouldn't need this from picture thing, but at least it gives you an idea of which pictures might have a better shot. I also made all the columns really wide, so there's no chance that they're gonna think that that dollar sign belongs to January. And we'll try this one. So data, from picture, from file. Analyzing your image. Now, it's interesting that there were far more to review here. Like, they weren't sure about the word June for some reason. That was correct. 2 of 7, the 1523, they randomly put a decimal point in, which seems weird, but at least they were worried enough about it to ask me. The 1538, they put a decimal point in. You know, and by the way, I'm using the default font. I'm using the default Excel font. It's not like I'm throwing some weird font at them. Gary, that one's right. Ike, that one's right. And then insert data. Yes, you're responsible for validating the accuracy of all data. How did this one do? Let's do this comparison. Okay, so I'm gonna paste in the real data here. And we'll come out and just do a test for equality. So is the from picture data equal to the original data? And copy that, 4, 5, 6, paste. Ah, yeah, all right. That actually introduced one error. They put BA space RB instead of barb and didn't catch it. I wanna love this feature, and I know that they're going to get there. It's going to be an amazing feature someday. But right now, I feel like every time I use it, I'm gonna have to go through and do a lot of proofing to make myself comfortable that it's working. And I'm giving them the best shot here in that I created this data in Excel and then took a picture of it from Excel. If it was a real photo, They do say consider the lighting, camera angles, and cropping the image to focus on the table to help us extract the data more accurately. This is just a mess. 6 items require review, and I can't even tell really what they're highlighting in the photo. I'll just accept all and insert data. I've looked at this a couple of times. I'm not even sure what is going on. Let's be nicer and crop it down to just those two columns. So I'll right click here and copy, and then from picture, from clipboard. All right, good. So at least they knew it was two columns. The 180.98, I can see that there. The negative 0.21, which is kind of cropped at the top, they just left me the one. So maybe we throw out that first row. Maybe that wasn't fair. Plus 74.21, minus 6.87, that looks good. Here, for some reason, they put those two in the same column. 35, I'll just accept all and we'll see what we get here. And then insert data. All right, it actually started out. Now, the 180.98, the 740.21, but where did the 122.56, how did that become 113.11? Now, hey, this is, I mean, it's definitely not fair. Look at how these are, you know, it was a round display board. This probably was not realistic to throw at them at all. They're going to get there, right? Voice recognition back in 1989 was terrible. But here we are 30 years later, and it all works great. With the right data set, there's a good chance that this will actually save you some time, but you definitely need to be careful and proof those results. Now, it's kind of exciting. You know, we haven't had a chance to play with this. It's been on Android for a long time, but I don't have an Android phone. And so, you know, this is great to give it a try. It's kind of like Christmas, but it reminds me of that Christmas where my cousin Joe gave me a sweatshirt instead of toys. You know, it's Christmas, but it's just not what you were hoping for. So, hey, if you're on Office Insiders and you have this new data from picture, give it a try. Let me know down in the YouTube comments if you had any success with it. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.